By the end of this video, you will learn the different stages of the writing process. In this course, one of my goals for my students is to discover their own unique writing process. While there are lots of plans and steps you can follow and find online, I want you to be able to discover what helps you create a clear and meaningful piece of writing. The stages of writing I will show you are flexible and recursive. That means you don't exactly follow the stages in the order I will show you, and you may select several strategies that work best for you. Also, it's normal and beneficial for you to jump back and forth between stages throughout your journey as needed. In the brainstorming stage, you are focusing on generating ideas, not perfect writing. Think of this as the trying on ideas phase. Some strategies you can use are webs. Webs are used to organize ideas, and sometimes this can be more frustrating than helpful because you may not have any ideas to make a web, but it's worth a try. Start with your main focus, and then begin branching out to more specific ideas that you can build into paragraphs. All the ideas you write down should help prove your main argument. Outlining. Outlining is a strategy that also requires you to start with some ideas already. Basically, you organize your thoughts in the order that makes the most sense at that moment. You can organize by paragraph, sentence. Over time, you can revisit your outline and rearrange things. When I outline, I sometimes use scissors and cut out each section of the outline and rearrange them by hand. That just helps me think better. Do what works for you. Free writing. This is the strategy I suggest more than any other because it requires no ideas to start. Using a stopwatch, time yourself for about 60 seconds. Write a list of words about your topic, anything that comes to your mind, and I mean anything. Even if it's random, jot it down. Also, don't stop writing. Don't try to think of ideas. Just let your pencil, pen, or keyboard lead the way. When time is up, look at your word list and circle words that you think sound interesting or that you can develop into paragraphs. Ask questions. A pre-writing strategy that is often ignored is asking questions. In this method, you simply wonder about your topic and be curious. Ask questions about your topic and write them down. Do some very informal research to get answers, like using Google. The point is you're letting your curiosity lead the way and discover new ideas. All of these methods can be used to generate ideas, and this doesn't just happen once at the beginning of the paper. Many times, my students return to brainstorming throughout the writing process to help them think through difficult parts of their paper and get more ideas. No matter what kind of pre-writing you do, it's important that during this stage you consider your purpose for writing, your audience who will read your work, and the form that your writing will take on. Thinking about these major ideas early on and continually during your writing will keep you focused on some big ideas. Drafting. First drafts are usually not very good at all. In fact, they can be a total mess. Learn to accept that. In the draft phase, you want to be kind to yourself, as kind as you were during brainstorming. Write down sentences in any order that makes sense to you, but make sure you have an introduction with a thesis statement, evidence to support your thesis, and a conclusion that shows why your argument is important. At this point, don't worry about grammar so much, but do try to be more mindful of it. Most of all, make sure your draft is complete. Some students leave out conclusions in a first draft because they're afraid it will be terrible, so they think, why bother? This is one of the most self-defeating things you can do in this stage because you won't have something to work with later on in your process. So make sure you write something down, even if you think it's terrible. Make sure you have a complete draft. Feedback. The feedback stage is when you share your writing and allow your readers to provide their opinion about your writing so that you can make necessary changes. You can share your writing with instructors, classmates, and tutors. In this class, you will share your writing with all three. While this may make you a bit nervous, okay, very nervous, you will soon understand that sharing your writing allows you to get a fresh perspective on your writing and improve your writing skills. It's best to ask specific questions when you share your writing so that the reviewer knows what you need help with. In addition to sharing your writing, you should also read plenty of sample writing during this stage. A helpful tip is while your paper is being reviewed and you're waiting for feedback, find a sample writing to read to learn what effective writing looks like. I will provide you with samples for each writing assignment, and you can read your classmates' writing, or you can even search online. Like all stages of writing, this stage is not visited just once during your writing process, but should be revisited as many times as necessary. Reflection. This is the part of the writing process where you think about your own writing. You consider what people have said about your writing, changes you need to make, samples you've read. Research has shown that people who stop and think about the task they are completing actually learn more than those who don't. In this class, you are required to stop and reflect about your writing a few times during each essay, and you will write about your writing, struggles, and victories. We will visit this stage a lot. Revising. Revising is not editing. In the revising stage, you will focus on ideas and not sentence issues. In other words, we won't worry about commas here. What you want to focus on are questions like this. Do I have a thesis statement that is arguing a point? Do I have evidence to support my ideas? Do I have a conclusion that's only summarizing, or am I showing why my topic is important, etc.? As you can see, these questions focus on the big picture, your argument, and how you are supporting your argument. In this stage, you will most likely erase entire paragraphs, delete ideas that you thought you loved, add more research. You will make big changes. Rest. This is a phase that I share with my students, as you may not find it in any writing textbook. It's important to look away from your writing. We do this for a number of reasons, but mostly reading your paper too much can limit your ability to catch errors or confusing ideas in your own writing. So try to take a break, somewhere between 24 to 48 hours, a few times as you write. That means don't leave the assignment until the last minute. Editing. Editing involves looking at each sentence carefully and making sure that it's well designed and serves its purpose. Proofreading involves checking for grammatical and punctuation errors, spelling mistakes, and things like that. For example, in this stage, you will delete commas, combine sentences, and focus on smaller details. But don't be fooled. Smaller details doesn't mean unimportant. Some writers, or even writing teachers, want to skip over this stage because they think, well, a comma doesn't mean so much. But the truth is, many writers are just too scared of grammar and editing because no one ever took the time to teach them all the fine details that can help make their writing achieve beauty. Also, I don't want to teach you grammar just to learn a bunch of rules. I want to teach you that grammar can actually help you create a more powerful argument and clear message. Grammar is a tool in how you say what you say, not just a set of rules. And lastly, we have publishing. Think of publishing as sharing your written work with an audience, a public audience. This is the sending off phase of your work. I think you work on this stage during the entire process because you've been sharing pieces of your writing with teachers, fellow classmates, but the final sharing happens when the intended audience reads your work. I mentioned earlier that you should jump from stage to stage as it helps your writing. And believe it or not, many writers revise their work after it has been published, myself included. You may do the same. For example, when you complete a writing assignment, you may use that writing again for another class and another assignment with some revision. Writing is a process, not just a product. You'll notice that I don't have arrows connecting any of these stages because you should jump back and forth between them as you see fit. Remember, writing can never be labeled perfect in the sense that it is unable to be altered for the better, but there does come a time when you put down the pencil or turn off the laptop and just let your writing speak. Good luck.